mission of tax so that they can import from countries outside East African community, you know, and then therefore not pay the 25%, I think, tax that is imposed on importing goods from outside the community. And the point she was making was that this list is too long and we should have a meeting and discuss it with the Burundi people to see how we can, on what we can agree. Then she had also pointed out there is a problem of currency convertibility, and that Burundi business people find it difficult to get dollars to pay for goods here. So the suggestion was that the Bank of Uganda should set up a currency center in Bujumbura to help the traders of both countries. That's as far as we had gone. And I propose, Mr. President, Your Excellencies, as you'll find out later on in our community, which we have already agreed, we want to suggest that we should have a joint permanent commission meeting where these trade issues are discussed in detail. Because right now, I think the trade counterpart is not here, but we could organize better and have a joint meeting between us with all the officials and having prepared for the agenda. So this should be captured, I think, in our communique. That's my suggestion. And then the third point.
Your Excellencies, the third point is we signed the agreement with the African Continental Free Trade Area as East African Community. We cannot start doing business before Burundi and Tanzania ratifies. Kenya has ratified, Uganda has ratified, Rwanda has ratified, South Sudan has, so it is only Burundi and Tanzania. So we pray, Your Excellencies, that that Burundi also ratifies, and later I think Tanzania will, so that we can do business with the African Continental Free Trade Area as a bloc. Those are my areas. But the JPM is the best idea because the manufacturers have got a number of issues like I alluded to in my presentation through foreign affairs. Thank you, Excellency. Maybe French.
Excellence le Président, avant de vous quitter, on nous avait donné l'ordre de venir tenir des discussions sur le commerce et tout autre problème de coopération entre les deux États. Nos deux États, donc le Burundi et l'Ouganda, sont partenaires de la communauté est-africaine et nous avons un protocole de douane, union des douanes. Nous avons donc pas de problème de barrières tarifaires qui nous empêchent pour le moment, mais ce qui fait que le commerce entre les deux États a accru de 40 millions jusqu'à 59 millions d'échanges par an en faveur de l'Ouganda, et ces produits qui sont importés du Burundi, par le Burundi comprennent, donc il y a le fer, il y a le tabac, il y a les haricots, il y a le maïs, il y a des huiles végétales, et puis il y a des produits de beauté. Mais il y a aussi du commerce informel qui se passe entre les deux États. Du côté du Burundi, les importations s'élèvent à 33,38 millions de dollars par an d'export vers l'Ouganda. Et ces produits qui sont importés par l'Ouganda comprennent l'or, il y a les ferrailles, il y a des problèmes de ferrailles, et puis il y a d'autres produits comme les peaux des animaux. Une concerne a été sur les vins, c'est le problème de rémission des droits douaniers. Une liste a été présentée par le Burundi vers la communauté est-africaine pour lui permettre de diminuer ou bien d'importer des produits hors des enceintes de la communauté est-africaine. Donc, qui pourrait amener à éviter de payer les 25% de taxes. Cette liste, tout d'abord, est trop longue. Et deux, cette liste comprend certains produits que le gouvernement fabrique. Donc, le Burundi trouve que c'est moins cher d'importer à l'extérieur de la communauté est-africaine. Ces produits comprennent le ciment et il y a le ferraille. Donc, nous souhaiterions que nous tenions une discussion, les prochaines priorités des deux États pourraient tenir des discussions afin de trouver un issue à ces problèmes. Deuxième problème que le ministre ougandais du Commerce a soulevé, c'est le problème de la convertibilité de monnaie. Il y a manque de dollars du côté du Burundi. Donc, ce qu'elle propose, c'est que la permission pour la Banque centrale ougandaise, Bank of Uganda, d'ouvrir à Bujumbura une succursale. Donc, de cette succursale, la Banque centrale ougandaise pourrait émettre les notes promissoires vers le secteur privé burundais afin de permettre les importations de se faire. Et je suis d'accord que la commission conjointe mixte commerciale pourrait tenir des discussions pour approfondir sur les problèmes que je viens d'évoquer. Troisièmement, le Burundi et l'Ouganda sont membres de la organisation commerciale au niveau continental, zone d'échange, mais pour le moment, le Burundi et la Tanzanie n'ont pas ratifié cet accord, qui fait que malgré que l'Ouganda, le Kenya, le Sud-Soudan sont déjà ratifiés, on ne peut pas commencer à faire le commerce entre nous en tant que bloc. Donc je crois que ces enceintes pourraient être discutées au niveau de la commission mixte qui pourrait se tenir prochainement.
So, Your Excellency, you are most welcome. That was the translation into French. You are most welcome because the relationship between Burundi and Uganda is an old one. We know one another for a long time, even before the Europeans came. Burundi were coming here from Kigoma, from Buha, according to Buha. There was a famous man, like a prophet, called Jejere, who came from, he was in Burundi. He was a wise man. Then during the colonial times, many Burundi came to work, and some stayed. Even now they are still here. So we are very happy in Uganda that there is peace in Burundi now. And from what you told me, there is reconciliation, which is going on. So therefore, what we need to do now is to deal with the economy. And as they are suggesting, a joint permanent commission is the best, because then they can discuss in detail rather than just ad-hocing. But there are clear cases which, like for instance, the mineral sector. Our people long ago told me, because we found petroleum here in Uganda in 2006, this is 15 years ago, we are now going to start using it. But at that time, when they discovered our oil here, they said Burundi is not so likely to have the same oil because the structure is the same. Rwanda may also have, but the problem of Rwanda are the volcanoes. Volcanoes could have, yes, the oil may have been there, but it could have been disrupted by the volcanoes. But in Burundi, there are no volcanoes. So I told His Excellency Nkurunziza that we could send people to check, to help him check. But I think they were busy with the internal issues. But these people are experts. We trained them. They are the ones who found our oil. Now, His Excellency has also told me about iron ore. I will also look for investors whom I can guide to go there. Then the communication. We talked about the road from Chikagate, Morongo, Isinjiro, they call it Isinjiro inside Tanzania, Keisho, Tukayanga. That road is an old Maram road. If it is graded and marmed properly, people can use it from the Mbarara side. But from the Mutukura side, Mutukura, Masaka, Kampala, the road from Mutukura, Chaka, Kayanga, Ngara is there already, because the Tanzanians have tarmacked from Chaka to, from Mutukura to Chaka, from Chaka to Kayanga. I don't think they have tarmacked Kayanga Ngara, but it's not very far. It may be like 30, 40 miles or something like that. So we can travel directly to Burundi. Therefore, on our side, I want you to look at the road from Murongo to Kayanga. We can also cooperate in the security fields. I will send some security people to come and see Your Excellency, to come and discuss in detail in Burundi. So, Your Excellency.
Thank you, Excellency. First of all, I'd like to thank you for all the attention deserves to our delegation since we arrived here. It was a particular attention for us, and we are happy. And also, as you know, Burundi consider Your Excellency yourself that you are like the father of our nation, because you gave yourself to help Burundi to bring peace and reconciliation, and now, as you say, Burundi is in peace because of Your Excellency. Burundi will not forget how you gave yourself, particularly in 2015, when you accepted to sacrifice yourself and coming by road when other countries were going out of Burundi, mm-hmm. thinking that there is a war. It was a sacrifice, and we thank you very much.
Thank you.
We came here to look for blessing as our elder. You are our elder, and you know, we passed a bad moment when our past president, Nkurunziza, died. It was one of who will be the very advice of Burundi, my advice, but unfortunately he passed away, and now is you to advise us how we continue to move. So as Burundi recovered peace and reconciliation, now we are going forward to socio-economic development. And you know that a long time ago it was every time the conflict for conflict, but now is the time to begin development, to look for the life of people. So as a vision country, we are searching everything. We have natural resources in Burundi. We are in a good region, so it is easy to do business with Uganda. And already we see many Ugandans coming to Burundi, and they would like investors also to come. We have many natural resources, mine, and also Burundi is an opportunity for tourism investment. You know, Lake Tanganyika is one of the wonderful area. We sometimes say Cote d'Azur. Tanganyika can be Cote d'Azur, the destination of the world for holidays. So in tourism also we can invest, and also we can exchange in many things. Agriculture also, you are in advance in agriculture, so we came to tell you the real situation of our country. Now the security is there, peace is there, and we are happy that we are supported by yourself, Excellence. We are happy. And to go forward, as you said, we need the meeting of Joint Commission that will work. They will work together as brothers, and I am sure that with you we will go through and we will win against poverty in Burundi. I was trying to talk in English. We are happy also that you support us in the East African community. As you know, we are now prepared to take the chair of East African community.
Yes.
And I'm sure that I will not lose when we are together. I have confidence in you, and we continue to advise us so that Burundi can be a country at the same level as others. But not that we are in the beginning, we can't not evaluate where we are when we are at the foundation. Consider that we are at the foundation, and we will need every time your support. I thank you very much for how you managed to receive us, and I thank you for all.
Thank you. So we are now going to go for lunch. Have you finished the joint communique? You read it then.
Excellencies, honorable ministers, we have a ceremony of the signing of the joint communique, which is going to be issued on the occasion of the visit to Uganda by His Excellency the President of Burundi. This communique is going to be signed by the ministers of foreign affairs of Uganda and Burundi. And thereafter, if you so wish, excellencies, you may make some additional remarks.
No, we have already made our remarks.
May I now invite the ministers of foreign affairs, Honorable Sam Kutesa and Honorable Albert Chingiro, to step forward to the table in front here.
I think, Patrick, let me first read it, then we sign it.
Okay.
So that we are signing the contents that the excellencies know about.
Thank you, sir.
Excellencies, this is a joint communique on the occasion of the state visit to Uganda by His Excellency Evariste Ndayishimiye, President of the Republic of Burundi, from 13th to 14th May 2021. One, at the invitation of His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, President of the Republic of Uganda, His Excellency Evariste Ndayishimiye, President of the Republic of Burundi, paid a two-day state visit to the Republic of Uganda from 13th to 14th May 2021. His Excellency Evariste Ndayishimiye was accompanied by the Foreign Minister of Affairs, the Minister of Foreign Affairs and Development Cooperation, and Ambassador Albert Chingiro, and other senior government officials. His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni congratulated His Excellency Evariste Ndayishimiye upon his successful election to the High Office of President of the Republic of Burundi, which attests to the confidence the people of Burundi have in his leadership. His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni expressed his condolences to His Excellency Evariste Ndayishimiye, the government and people of the Republic of Burundi, upon the passing of His Excellency Pierre Nkurunziza, former President of the Republic of Burundi. He hailed the former president for his efforts towards the reconstruction of the country and embracing ethnic diversity. His Excellency President Ndayishimiye congratulated President Yoweri Museveni upon his election as President of the Republic of Uganda and commended his statesmanship and commitment to peace, stability, and socio-economic transformation of Uganda and the region at large. Further, he further commended His Excellency President Yoweri Museveni for his efforts as a guarantor to the Arusha Peace Accord and a mediator in the inter-Burundi dialogue. The heads of state said, held official talks at State House Entebbe in a cordial atmosphere and reviewed bilateral, regional, and international issues of mutual interest. At bilateral level, their excellencies noted the existing bonds of friendship and cooperation between Uganda and Burundi. They agreed to boost cooperation in various sectors, including agriculture, energy, trade, health, finance, tourism, investment, transport and communication, ICT, defense and security, education, culture and sports. In this regard, they directed their respective ministers to ensure that implementation of existing agreements, memorandums of understanding and other frameworks of cooperation is fast-tracked. The two heads of state stressed the need to increase the volume of bilateral trade between the two countries by bringing together the respective private sectors to identify opportunities for trade and investment. They also underscored the need to enhance infrastructure connectivity, such as improving road transport networks to connect both countries. They welcomed the designation of Uganda Airlines that has started direct flights between Bujumbura and Entebbe, which would greatly improve connectivity between the two countries and promote trade, tourism, and investment. Their Excellencies directed their Ministers of Foreign Affairs to convene a meeting of the third session of the Joint Permanent Commission and a joint business forum within the next 6 months. Their Excellencies took note of the current status of the outbreak of COVID pandemic in the region and agreed to strengthen surveillance and control measures in response to COVID-19 and other pathologies with epidemic potential between the two countries. Their Excellencies reiterated their commitment towards implementing agreed measures in achieving deeper integration in the African community and the wider African Union. We welcome the entry into force of the agreement established in the African Continental Free Trade Area on 1st January 2021, which will help boost Africa trade development, value gains, and integration. The heads of state exchanged views on the security situation in the region and underscored the need to maintain peace, security, and stability in the Great Lakes region and in the African continent as a whole. They commended the African Union mission in Somalia for its role in pacifying the country, including the fight against terrorist groups. They called upon the international community to continue supporting the government of Somalia in building its institutions, especially the National Army, to ensure the progress and gains made are consolidated. At the international level, the two heads of state agreed to deepen their cooperation in regional and international organizations on issues of common interest. They underlined the importance for the African continent to speak with one voice in intergovernmental negotiations on global challenges, such as climate change, the fight against terrorism, the reform of the United Nations Security Council, international migration, as well as the implementation of sustainable development goals. The two heads of state welcomed the withdrawal of Burundi from the agenda of the United Nations Security Council and the African Union Peace and Security Council, as well as the lifting of the sanctions against Burundi by several of its partners. They therefore called on Burundi's partners, who have not yet lifted the remaining sanctions imposed on Burundi in 2015, to lift them immediately in order to boost the socio-economic development of the country. His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni expressed gratitude to His Excellency Evariste Ndayishimiye for honoring his invitation and for the fruitful discussions held. His Excellency Evariste Ndayishimiye thanked His Excellency President Yoweri Museveni, the government and people of Uganda, Republic of Uganda, for the warm hospitality accorded to him and his delegation during the visit. His Excellency Evariste Ndayishimiye extended an invitation to His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni to visit the Republic of Burundi. The invitation was gladly accepted, and the dates will be agreed upon through diplomatic channels, dated at Entebbe on 13th May 2021.
Proposer amendment.
Okay.
You see, my French is not bad. The amendment is on Museveni with the East African Arusha effort. So you should add working with Mwalimu Nyerere, Nelson Mandela, I think also Jacob Zuma. You should add that.
Okay.
You can sign and add them later.
Thank you, Your Excellency. So we shall find time to sign it ourselves with that, with the proposed amendment.
Yes.
Thank you.
You signed the last page. So and Ben Mkapa. Mkapa was also involved. Okay, we go manger.
Thank you.